ba bang ba kopa di change. Na ba le kitse ba mphezuka ba bang kutlwile. It's a new day, it's a brand new day. I want to welcome all of you in the house. And a special welcome also to our visitor.
Re amogela baeng ba rona.
And last week kitse re tlele baeng ne.
Last week I said we must bring visitors.
Nda nga tu Jesu ni mthatheli koptune.
Korobile na sentle ntle ge ke bua ga lenke le tlhoko.
Hey, let's invite people.
Are la letseng batho.
Gore even when they pass away, some of them, ne? We celebrate because they gave their life to Christ. Wouldn't you be happy to know that you are one of those people in them giving their lives to the Lord?
That had an influence.
It's a privilege.
To live in the presence of the Lord, ke monyetla o mogolo thata.
Re rumilwe.
We ascend.
Tender itswile.
Tender itswile. We have been given a tender.
Ya bophelo bo bo sa feleng.
Of everlasting life.
As Mama Philly was ministering about love.
Jaka Mama Philly ntsa bua ka lerato.
O ka se kgone go minister to people who are born, who are not born again, if you are not filled with the love of God.
Because we are not doing this with our own strength.
That is the heart of the Father this morning.
We're
still talking about the unrelenting Father. Continuing from last week. So this is part two. And I also want to acknowledge and thank my pastor for giving me an opportunity to minister. And to those who are connecting via social media, you are welcome this morning. Please participate as we partake of the word this morning. Just to remind ourselves of what some of the things I said last week about the unrelenting Father. The unrelenting Father is constant. He is persistent and continual, unwavering and resolute when it comes to us as his children or sons. He is unrelenting in pursuing us until we come to a level of sonship. When it comes to a personal level, I said we have to confess that God is unrelenting towards me. He's showing me unrelenting, or he's unrelenting in his love. He doesn't give up on you. Very patient.
God is not like people.
Because he is the one who made you. And I said that the lens through which we must see the Bible. When we read, when we study, is the lens of a father and his son. The first Adam, he was an orphan. Actually, he became an orphan. And because of that, he disobeyed God. Because of that disobedience, he hid himself away from the Father. But the last Adam,
me Adamo wa bofelo,
Jesus Christ,
Jesu Christe,
came to show us,
atla gore bontsha,
he came to demonstrate what sonship looked like.
Atla gore bontsha gore borwa bo tshwana le eng.
He came to demonstrate what an intimate father-son relationship looks like.
Atla gore bontsha gore kamano ya morwa le ntate e tshwanetse go nna yang.
So this is our reminder as a church. The father is looking for a son to relate with. And it's only through sonship, oneness, and alignment that we will be able to bring heaven on earth. Sons are a conduit.
Barwa ke tsamaiso.
They are a transportation, a vehicle.
Ke koloi e tsamaisang.
Through which the Lord wants to impact earth.
E modimo wena batlang go ama lefatshe ka yona.
With heaven realities.
Ka dinnete tsa legodimo.
And I also said,
e bile ke buile gape kare.
Ke itseng kana mamagadi. He said, your identity in Christ will make you stand out.
I said again,
you know, there's something different about you as a child of God. And those that don't love God, they pick it up easily. That's why they make you suffer. And most of them will not love you. Because you are set apart.
Don't be forced to be loved.
That anointing.
We don't want to defy that anointing.
Remember that you are a city on a hill. There's no way
you can light a candle and put it under the bed.
Your identity as a son of God, it sets you apart. And understanding your identity in Christ, it will set you apart. Number two, it will propel you for aggressive advancement pursuits. Kingdom aggressive advancement pursuits. You can only do that when you understand you, your identity, your authority, your position, or else you will never be able to function as a son if you have no clue who you are. I said also, an orphan behaves less of a son. He looks down upon himself, but a son always looks up to the father. And the key that qualifies us for the father's blessings repentance. Is to return. Is to obey. I know that between last week Sunday and today, life happened. Sin happened. We spoke things we were not supposed to speak. We made choices we were not supposed to make. We made decisions that were contrary to the will of God. But the Father says, come back. Come as you are. Don't reason when it comes to dilo tsa Modimo.
When it comes to God's things,
don't apply logic.
Wena oska diri sa tlhaloganyo.
Be propelled by his love.
Wena khurumeletswa ka le rato la gagwe.
He is called our everlasting father for a reason.
Ena o bitswa modimo wa bosa khutling ka lebaka.
Use that truth.
Wena dirisa nnete eo.
To come back to him.
Gore o boele kwa go ene. Amen.
Through the Bible. When you read the Bible, you will see that there's one theme where the Lord desires for the orphan to come back, for the son to realize his sonship, returning to divine design, and come back to his senses. The Bible says, the truth will set you free, and whom the Son sets free is free indeed. So it is by knowing this truth, understanding this truth, living this truth, in other words, making this truth, the word of God, your lifestyle. So that even if you fall, He's able to pick you up, because it is that truth that opens your eyes to know who you are. And if you know who you are, you do not remain in the fallen state. It is the truth of his word that makes us to come back to our senses. You know, coming back to your senses,
it's just like when somebody steps on your feet or your toes.
And then that old Adamic nature.
And then you are surprised when your old self comes back.
You know what follows afterwards? After the anger, guilt comes. Yo, Lord, I'm sorry. Forgive me. Why? It is the truth that is within you that helps you to come back to your senses, because now you remember, this is not who I am. I am the Son of the Living God. Because when I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But because I have hidden this truth in my heart, the truth of God is the eye salve. That heals
their blindness.
Now that I see, I no longer speak as I spoke. That's why the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 4, do not let any corrupt word come out of your mouth. It also says, because of this truth, the word of God within us, let him who stole steal no more. Why? We are leveraging on the newness of life. The newness of life. Yes, and I also said that when we read about the nation of Israel, we must see that nation as the Son of God. In Hosea 11, chapter 1, the word of God says, when Israel was a child, I loved him. And I called my son out of Egypt.
Kabitsa morwa wa ka kutsa kwa ho Egypt.
Out of Egypt.
Kutsa kwa Egypt.
Before we knew him, let's keep the scripture on the screen. Before we knew him, we lived in darkness. We were controlled by the world system. And the Bible says we were once darkness. But now that we know him, the Bible says that he translated us out of darkness, out of ignorance, out of the orphan spirit, into the kingdom of light, the kingdom of truth, the kingdom of his son. You may have been taken out of Egypt. But how much of Egypt are you allowing to control you? How much of Egypt are you still entertaining? What is it that is of Egypt that still feels so attractive to you? When they were in the wilderness, when they were on their way to the promised land, because of the challenges they experienced, the son was a murmurer, a complainer, ungrateful son. And then they started to miss the food. The food.
You know, food can remove you from the presence of God. They can remove you from the position that God has put you. I'm going there just to support my friend.
No, ba celebrate a fail.
No, ba itumela fela ke party nya na fela.
Ba phahlile go seng.
But they did ba party.
To dedicate everything to the idols.
Ba netse dilo tsotlhe ko ba dingwane.
You are there.
Wena o teng mo.
Na ke nagana gore once o gata mabala ao.
Imagine once you step in there. You are in there.
You are responsible.
Wena o responsible.
To be a discerning person. He has taken us out of darkness into light. And we have to walk in the light. The Bible says you must walk circumspectly.
Amen.
Redeeming the time. Because the days are evil. We can no longer afford identity crisis as the church. We have to arise as sons. Ya lukisiwa taba ya di tender.
We fix these things of tenders.
The world is also hungry for righteous rule. The Bible says, woe to you when your king is a child. We are expecting, we are hungry for a new South Africa. How ready are you as a child of God, full of dominion, anointed? How ready are you to occupy those other places where the earth is looking for righteous rule? I love this scripture in Jeremiah 3:19. In NLT. I thought to myself, I would love to treat you as my own children. I wanted nothing more than to give this beautiful land the finest possession in the world. I looked forward to your calling me Father, and I wanted you to never turn from me. That's what Christianity is all about. That's what church is all about. You know, he is looking for people to have an intimate relationship with, where the Father is one with the Son, where the body of Christ is one with the head of the body. You will see the pictures of oneness also in the Bible. When the Lord looked for a man, he does not go to a group. He went to Moses. That was the picture of the one man, Jesus. When, is it Gideon? Was recruiting people. Come, let us go. God did not want matriti-triti.
God did not want a whole lot of people.
He just wanted, Gideon was enough. And he said to Gideon,
if it was not with, about your plans,
I would have defeated this nation one man.
Where
na uli one.
You alone.
The thing e go kgoreletsang go dira mmereko wa Modimo.
The thing silo se se kgoreleditseng to do the work of the Lord.
Maybe you don't believe that you are enough.
Ke kan tla gore wena ga o tshepe gore wena o lekane.
The burden will be felt by you. Even people maybe in your home cell or e-session may not feel the burden, but I'm here to remind you that God can do it through you when you are determined.
You
alone. Stop recruiting. Go and do that assignment. It is God who gave you that assignment in the first place. And before the children of God would enter the promised land, which they didn't because of their murmuring, God warned them about those seven nations that they need to overcome the spirit of the Amorites, Canaanites, Hittite, Perizzites, Hivites, Jebusites, and the Gergashites. So in order for us as a church to become aggressive in our pursuit of kingdom business, we have to overcome worldly and external influence. And throughout the Bible, the Lord is warning us, like one of the examples is, you have never seen God. God is spirit. So ukanka yang selo se Modimo mupi wa legodimo le lefatshe a di tlodileng o bonka legong o bo bopa something o bo re ke yena Modimo wa ka.
How would you take the things that God has created and made your own God out of?
There is nothing on earth that you can we tshwareletse ka yona rai ke Modimo. No, God cannot be seen.
That you can hold on and say he is, that is God.
He says those who worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. In the last days. So we are in the last days. He says the day will come and now is that time. True worshippers Worshippers that are full of truth and the word of God. They worship from spirit with a capital S to a small s to spirit with a capital S.
There is nothing that you can hold on.
Hana.
Refuse. Refuse to hold those things.
To let anything stand proxy.
No,
it's
just water. Mm-mm. No.
The just shall live by faith. And those who come to God must believe that He exists. They must believe that He alone, He is enough.
I don't need to help Him. God loves us.
And the Lord our Father has created us to be the radiation and expression of His glory. Sons have to rise and be aggressive in advancing kingdom business. Because we as sons, we are the answer to the constriction that earth is experiencing. No creature has ever been created in the image of God but us as human beings. Romans
9:8-19.
In NLT.
NLT.
Whether, you know, in different versions, it says the same thing. For all creation is waiting. Eagerly. For that future day. When God will reveal who His children are.
Amen.
Laiutwa. Loko Yesu abambiwa shambanweni.
Khamu Jesu ane abo abapulwa ko sfapano.
The Bible says huile hwa fifala.
The Bible says it became dark.
Creation suffered. If He dies, what about us? But the Lord already had a plan.
Because He raised you as a son.
The Bible says, Satan did not know about the plan of God. The plan of redemption. If he knew, He would not have crucified the King of Glory, the Lord of Glory. It was for us. It was for creation. And King James Version says, for the earnest expectation of the creature waiteth for the manifestation of the sons of God.
When
sons of God.
It's us.
Male and female.
Ba,
the body of Christ.
Mele wa ga Kreste.
Manifestation means you have to show up.
Bona tshego era gore wena o tshwanetse go tlhagella.
As a son of God.
Jaaka morwa wa Modimo.
Why is creation waiting for your manifestation?
Goreng tlholego yana e emetse gore wena o itlhagise.
Let's look at Psalm 115 verse 16.
Are lebelle Psalome 115. Temana 15.
The Bible says the heaven.
Bible iri magodimo.
Even the heavens.
Le magodimo.
Are the Lord's.
Kitsa Modimo.
But
me fela.
Say but
me re me.
The earth, let us read but
ari we say mogo me fela lefatshe.
The earth
lefatshe.
He has given to who?
Lona o le neile bomang.
You
wena
us
rona.
So tender itsule khale.
You see the tender has already gone.
How are you partaking?
Wena tia karolo.
Utia jang karolo.
How do you take a part?
Are you aware of that scripture? Please keep the scriptures on the screen. Are you aware of this truth?
Awena witi niti e.
The earth he has given to the children of men. That's why creation is waiting for us to manifest. So if you are not understanding, this morning we have need for sight. You cannot advance aggressively if you are blind. What is the enemy selling that has blinded you?
Amen.
You cannot arise. You cannot advance aggressively if you are blind. But the word of God is a cure for blindness.
Amen.
It's beautiful. Revelation
3:18.
I counsel you to buy from me gold refined in the fire, that you may be rich, and white garments, that you may be clothed, that the shame of your nakedness, Adam, may not be revealed, and anoint your eyes with eye salve, that you may see. Eye salve is the word of God. The word of God is pure. The word of God enlightens. The Bible says, your word is a lamp to my feet. Your word is a light unto my path. Re tlhoka lefoko la Modimo to be able to walk circumspectly.
We need the word of God.
It is a cure for blindness. And all of these things, the blindness, the nakedness, poor, poverty, Jesus dealt with it on the cross. But you have to arise and receive it by faith. We have to rise and proclaim and declare and, you know, be repentative in our approach. Come back to him. Walk in obedience to the relentless Father. How many of you remember the story of the prodigal son? Luke 15, that story.
Luke 15.
Hey. The original story, sir, I blew it. The one started here in the Bible. But you know, we don't know the name of this son. All we know is that he's the son. Sonship is very important. We are going to read from Luke 15, from 11 to 31. If you know the story, ne? I'm just going to read it. I will see. Let me just read. Then he said, a certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falls to me. So he divided to them his livelihood, and not many days after, the younger son gathered all together, journeyed to a far country, and there wasted his possessions with prodigal living or reckless living. But when he had spent all, there arose a severe famine in that land, and he began to be in want. Then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into the fields to feed swine, pigs. And he would gladly have filled his stomach with the pods that the swine ate, and no one gave him anything. Verse 17, but when he came to himself, he said, how many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare? And I will perish with hunger. I will arise and go to my father and say to him, Father, I've sinned against heaven and before you, I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants. Verse 20 says, and he arose and came to his father. But when he was still a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran, fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said to him, Father, I've sinned against heaven and in your sight, meaning that I've sinned against the divine father and you as my covering here on earth. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son, but the father, said, he was disrupting this flow of words. Bring out the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his hand and sandals on his feet, and bring the fatted calf here and kill it, and let us eat and be merry, for this son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found. And they began to be merry. I think I'll end right there. I'm not interested in Abutolo na lengkwal a o tla ipona.
Ke tla ema fa gare tswelle pele.
La ipona mar.
Do you see this?
Go khae.
At home.
Ao boa busigo.
When you come back.
I'm not saying o boa busigo ne.
I'm not saying.
I'm just painting a picture.
I'm just painting this picture. What do they say?
Who raf?
Go back where you come
from. If sampane o mekamekana le di relationship tsa moko lefatseng batswadi ba rona ha bana capacity.
If you are still buela
mo tswang go teng,
go back where you come from, where my mother does not see us.
Ayo ka ka English mama khadi.
Hey, wait.
When my mother does not see us, yo. If Bomb Minister of English were here, Government of National Unity, what? You are not dwelling on the highest level.
Amen.
Buela mo otswang.
Go back where you come from.
Why?
Goreng.
They are angry.
Kantla gore ba kwatile.
Ba buile le wena utlwe.
They talked to you and you don't listen.
Because you did not see their words as the cure for deafness.
Kantla gore wena ga wa bona mafuko a bona jaaka go.
They are frustrated.
Bona ba ne ba tlhakatlhakane.
Because wena o ithatela groove.
You love groove.
Maybe if Nabaka
maybe if you would go with them to
yebo. Maybe lebona Nabaka plomanya na shem. Marba groove ile kana go tseletsa tsa marabi ne.
But they had their fun.
Now ke nako ya batsha.
Now it's that is batsha time.
O reng modimo kolona.
What does God says to you?
He loves the youth.
O rata batsha.
How can a young man keep God's ways is to hide the word of God in their heart.
Ibe
software in this hardware.
It
hoka upgrade kana kotsotlhe.
Wena o di tse o tsenya lefoko la modimo mo go wena
ka matsatsi le matsatsi. To the prodigal son. The orphan looks down upon himself, but the son looks up to the father. When our heavenly father, the relenting father, when he ceases to be your shepherd,
apallwe.
Hawena.
Asapalwe ke gonna modisa wa gago.
He sees ho tshwa rwena o rae mina ke ngizo zenzela ngizo siphandela. Ho tshwa rwena o setse motlohela wa iketsetsa no wa bona?
When you are doing your own thing.
You remain in want.
Wena o ntse o batla o tlhoka.
O sala o ntse o tlhoka o batla.
Amen.
O sena.
Amen.
Because he is no longer your shepherd. Because the Bible says, with God. Ibuaka kamano relationship.
Ibuaka kamano.
Ibuaka oneness. Ibuaka partnership.
Ibuaka khudirisa.
That's why he says, without me. You can do nothing. So what does it mean to be in want? Is to decrease. Is to make lower. To fail. We see here in the portion of scripture that the younger son claimed his portion of the estate. He left the father to a far country. What does all this mean? The son moved away from the Calvary.
It's
powerful.
Amen.
Verse 1 to 2. Iri he who dwells.
Iri ena otletsing.
Odulang. Who dwells in the secret place of the Most High God.
Wanting motsireletsong ya mogodimo dimo.
Shall abide.
Ena utlile go nna.
Under.
Ka motlase.
The shadow.
Ga moriti.
Of the Almighty.
Ya mothata yotlhe.
I will say of the Lord. He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him I will trust. Do you know that the word dwell there, it means to marry. To remain. Even to abide. It's to make God your dwelling place.
Amen.
And secret means hiding place. It means protection. Can you see what is in this box? Box.
What
so
do you
if
see?
Satan o tla go batla a go bone kae?
If the devil will be looking for you, where would he be looking?
If you are hidden,
how are we iphitlile?
O tshwanetse a mekane le mang pele.
He must come and fight first.
Sene manje wena.
Be anong you.
Loko humala.
O tswafa.
Under the covering.
O tswa mo tshireletso.
Of the mighty God.
Sireletso ya modimo o kwa magodimong.
Are you not exposed?
A wena ga wa itlhagisa.
Akaso gatagate Satan.
Is he not going to step on you?
Because you are no longer under that covering.
Ka ntla ya gore wena ga o sa le mo khupetso.
You are exposed.
Wena o tlhagisitse.
There are vultures.
Gona le manong.
That are looking.
Ba shebile.
To destroy.
A batlang go
sina. Because you are no longer covered.
Ka ntla ya gore wena ga o sa le mo khupetso mo tshireletsong.
Secret means protection. It says, I will dwell under the shadow. That means defense. He is my refuge. He is my shelter. He is my trust. Sure. My fortress. I will trust in him. It means I put my confidence in him. All of that. The son left it. The prodigal son left. And more he left behind. I have a question for you this morning. Are you still dwelling with God? In God? Or have you left?
utlochile.
Haba checka register.
When they mark the register.
Ingaba elako ikamalikona na.
Alina lakakulona liteng.
Why do sons live?
Kuremba roba tamaya.
The Lord reminded me of the parable of the sower. They can live because, you know, they are not rooted because of persecutions, the worries of this life and deceitfulness. You can just read at home Matthew 13:18-23. Back to the prodigal son. He moved away from covering. He moved from fellowship. He moved away from doctrine. He moved away from covenant. The son moved away from his father's protection. He moved away from accountability, maikarabelo. The son moved away from breaking bread with the father. He moved away from favor. He moved away from ownership.
Where did he go?
To a foreign nation. Where he was a stranger. People with other covenants. Right there in that strange foreign land. He wasted his possessions with reckless living. I blew it, I saw Bonnie Nix. You know those people, ne? No, today robua ka batho ba bang a ke ra a selona.
Yeah, amen. Today re tlo bua ka batho ba bang.
Once di chelete ditswa.
You know when money is there,
you will know them.
O tlo go ba itse.
O bona na le dikavela tsa dikhala ka ofela.
You will see cavelas with all colors.
All yo bona go jiwa dipizza go jiwa eng a ke ra a e berekela.
All kinds of food because he did not work for that money.
Ha tlhompe.
He does not respect that money.
Ka Setswana ba reng khumo magwagwa yetsang ya tlotlorela.
Khumo le swagwa se a pharu.
Whatever it grows wings. Ya fufa wa ba utlwa ba itse Setswana phala English ba. La bona sa tswa Setswana ya no. Mara la ntshwara ke re.
Hey.
And jiggy ba rai rona re bone fela setsa rexa laptop o re balance kana ko 150.
You only see when he starts selling things that money is no longer.
Mara no gona le 5 million.
But that person had 5
that
million.
Is the spirit of an orphan.
Oh ke mo wa wa buhutsana.
And most of these series a ke di sheba ne
me di series tse he ke di lebella
a ke bone bontate ba le teng in the picture.
There's no many in
I'm
this.
Talking about there's biological fathers who are present.
No fathers.
I know her, even if there are fathers in the picture.
You
come with Kenya 10,000
what will you do with the pockets filled with 10,000?
License dikoloi.
They buy cars without having license.
Driver.
They have drivers.
And you know Mammon, the spirit of Mammon.
Wa itse mowa o wa go rata tshelete.
A o rata tshelete ke moya.
Ke mowa wa tshelete.
O rata ha gontse go le yalo.
It loves that situation.
A go bontse bo humanege ba hao.
And it will show you gore wena o khutsana.
Chelete ha ebereke if you are not under the covering.
Money does not work if wena gawa kupetiwa.
Instead, it will reflect, it will expose you.
Uyona itile kuhutlachisa.
And the spirit of the orphan within you.
Mimo ya wabuhutana utile kuhutlachisa.
The Bible says he wasted.
Bible ire asinya.
Hai berekela, he inherited it. He never worked for anything.
Hai berekela chelete e ui amuchetzi.
Waitu konalba tubailungore, they don't respect something because they had no appreciation for it because unahana unali this sense of entitlement.
Kunali ba tubailung kurba kase trumpi kwaza haba trumpi di lokan kahur banahana kur diba tswanet.
He spent all asalas na lisen.
Asna silo adirisa chelete yo wot.
Because he put his trust not in the Father, but in his possessions. Reminds me of that story about the rich young ruler. You can still be in Christ and be rich.
Amen.
Hmm.
Amen.
You can't say no if kiaregisa eko kawate hamo plus bari so vat. As poor as a church mouse, ke but like Africans. Kerk
maize.
Madir tusagang dilo zogo di interview. As groot as a vat. Go primary school ne rutwa metlholo its. Abar as fat as bagane bares ozimpo, but your mama ka maybe. I'm telling you. So the rich young ruler would not depart.
Musi o omwa muhumi una asakoni atrochela.
Because Jesus says, go and sell. Give to the poor.
Unele ba humanehi.
I want, that's my desire. Chore mudimo aresenulele chore. What is it? How does it feel to have him and know that I am content with him? And then all these things, Seridi Batlang, will be added unto
us.
The prodigal son lacked wisdom. He lacked wisdom to know that he had become an orphan. He never applied the principles of sowing and reaping. Else he would have invested. The son was short-sighted. He lived for the moment. And he experienced lack. As if that was not enough, there was famine. He began, it's a process, to be in want. Because he was no longer shepherded by the Father. And as a result, he had forgotten the principles of asking, seeking, and knocking. As a result of being in want, the Bible says he joined himself to a citizen of that country, a foreigner, a person outside covenant. Bona. By connecting yourself to someone who's outside the covenant of God, a foreigner. You are violating the covenant of your father. He left his sonship in pursuit of being an orphan. I love Ecclesiastes 10:7. I have seen slaves on horseback while princes go on foot like slaves. He moved from being an owner to being an employee. His job description, feeding swine. He His job description was feeding swine.
Tiro ya gagwe ene e le go fepa dikolobe.
Swine.
Kolobe.
Ena ba e rata bonkgono la gopola o entse ntho tse snacks. It's a symbol of uncleanness.
Kolobe ke setshwantsho sa go se tlhweki.
Ignorance, hypocrisy.
Go tlhoka kitso.
Unbelievers.
Go tlhoka tumelo.
He hungered for swine food.
Ena a eletsa dijo tsa dikolobe.
A different doctrine altogether.
Dijo thuto e farologaneng.
You know what was worse? The Bible says no one offered him even the pig's food. Say finally, the son came back to himself. Spirit, soul, and body. And these are all necessary for abundant living. Because the son had gained inheritance, possessions, but he lost his soul. What good is it to gain the whole world, to have all the possessions, and lose your soul? Your soul is the seat of emotions. That's where you make decisions. That's where you understand the word, you meditate on the word. David says, restore my soul. The body of Christ is in need for soul restoration. He gained inheritance and lost his soul.
When he's out, down and out.
Now he's so longed for divine design. And the Bible says he spoke to himself. You have to speak to yourself. Tasa lotion untsu bua le wena.
Put that lotion while you are in that conversation.
Tasa vaseline untsu bua le wena.
Tasa vaselina while you are in that conversation.
Untsu blessa mele wa gago ka lefoko la modimo.
Bless your body with the word of God.
Ikhopotse gore lefoko la modimo le reng ko wena.
Remind yourself, what does the word of God say to you?
Hantsu ichebile ko se iponeng.
While you are looking at the mirror.
Because sometimes it gets too quiet.
Because kana ko tsedi ngudi di malatha.
We learn from David. Why are you disquieted within me, oh my soul? Psalm 103, it bless the Lord, oh my soul. The sons have to engage the soul. All of us in spirit, soul, and body, we matter for the kingdom business. When I look at this prodigal son, he also experienced his own famine. Personal and spiritual famine. But once he spoke to his soul and said, I will arise and go to my father, he thought about it, he spoke it until it was settled in his spirit. And now his body was in agreement. That's why he arose to do that which he's been meditating upon. Your body is important in pursuing kingdom, aggressive kingdom business.
Moho salen kubata puso ya mudimu kachaka.
You can think about something.
Ukanahana kasing.
Speak about it.
Wabua kaso.
You still need your body to carry you to do that action.
Wena osense na ubata miluaha kuhuru ukono kuta maisa ukono kudira silosi.
I will arise and go to my father. What kind of a father was he returning to?
Nakitlohona no hake konta tekinta tomu yang omuro o anengabuela kwahuene.
The unrelenting father.
Kintate osa paluing osa feluing.
Loving.
Parle rato.
Resolute.
O a aikemiseditse.
Forgiving, empowering.
O itswarelang anatlafatsa.
Gracious.
Atletse mu limo mu.
Persistent.
O atsama a.
The son chose to come back to shelter and covering.
Murwa ena a swetsa go boela go khupetsong.
The son made good on his promise to himself. The son chose to defy stagnation. He chose to defy gravity, that which weighed him down. He chose to remember his kingliness or kingly regality and authority. Hear this. Return to the unrelenting father while there is still time. We don't have forever. One day we will die. But the Bible says Mudimu he takes pleasure in the death of his of the saints. He takes pleasure in the death of his saints. Yes. So here's the attitude of the unrelenting father. When he saw the son a great distance off, or when the son was far, he saw him. He had compassion. Ran to the son. Fell on his neck. Neck is a symbol of strength, humility. Kissed him. The depth of a son's repentance. Is matched only by the depth of the unrelenting father's love. In this story, we see how the father honors the repentant son. And our unrelenting father welcomes back. Receives us, celebrates us, bring out all those things that he said must be brought. And he says, let us be merry. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. The robe is a symbol of covering. A ring is a symbol of endlessness. Eternity, authority. A calf is a symbol of sacrifice. Sandals are a symbol of servant wood. And because he said, let us all celebrate, it was a let us kind of a vibe here. What I learned about this teaching, there is celebration in community and corporiety. The father doesn't celebrate you in secret. The father celebrates the restoration of sonship. The for everything that you do with him in the secret place. Under his covering. He celebrates you in public. This is my beloved son. In whom I am well pleased. That is the heart of the Father. And as I close, arise to your position. Arise to your posture as a son of God. Your posture of sonship. Assume your position. You heard the scripture says, why do you walk like a slave? When you're supposed to have ascended on horseback. Assume your position, which is higher. And not walk like a slave. Walk in dominion. Knowing that now you are under the shelter of the mighty God. Our unrelenting Father. I pray that in Jesus' name. Father, thank you for revealing your heart.
Yes, Lord.
To us as a church, as the body of Christ.
Hallelujah.
Out of Egypt, you've called your son. It's the same with us, Lord. You've called us out of a dark place into the kingdom of your son.
Lord.
A marvelous kingdom.
Yes, Lord.
A kingdom of power.
Yes, Father.
Father, your word says that your throne is in heaven and you have your kingdom rules over all.
Yes, Lord.
The kingdoms of this world are becoming the kingdoms of our Father.
In Jesus'
name. And he and his Christ and he shall rule forever and ever.
Yes, Lord.
Father, the returning is celebrated.
Hallelujah.
Because the son has an assignment.
Yes, Lord.
May we be those sons, Father,
Jesus,
who discern the times that are evil, choose to walk circumspectly.
Yes, Lord.
And remain with you, remain in you,
yes,
as our
Lord.
Dwelling place.
Yes, Lord.
Father, I have prayed. I thank you.
Yes, Lord.
For your grace this morning.
In Jesus' name.
We thank you that this word will settle in our hearts.
Yes, Lord.
This word will germinate until Christ is formed in us and we are totally transformed.
Yes, Lord.
To walk in our position, to posture ourselves as sons and to walk in authority.
Yes, Lord.
Creation, South Africa, is longing for a righteous rule.
Yes, Lord.
Father, your people are here. Those that have been doubting, Lord, I speak against that doubt that they know that they are enough as long as they have you.
Yes,
you
Lord.
Will order their steps.
Yes, Father.
You will give them counsel. They will know where to go, who to speak to, but
Hallelujah.
Mandate
in Jesus' name.
Creation is groaning for the manifestation.